You must have heard that exercise helps you stay fit. When you exercise, your energy multiplies twice, thrice, or even more. Yes, you are in the right class, and this is mathematics. As you exercise, your energy multiplies and you acquire power. Similar is the case with numbers. As numbers multiply, they also acquire power. So here x is multiplied 2 times, so it acquires a power of 2. We write it x raised to the power 2 and we can call it x square. Here x multiplies with itself 3 times and it acquires a power of 3. So we call it x cube or x to the power 3. Here x multiplies with itself 4 times and acquires a power of 4. So this is x to the power 4. Now suppose you are standing alone. There is someone who comes and troubles you. What can you do? All you can do is block him alone. So you just have the power of one individual, that is, you just have your own power to block that person. Similar is the case with this X. This X is also standing alone. It is not multiplied with any other variable. So what is the power of this X? Its power is 1. Because it is not multiplied with anything else. But suppose you and your friend are standing together and then someone comes and tries to trouble you. What will you do? Both of you together will block that person. So now you have your power and your friend's power to block him. So you have the combined powers of both of you to block him. Here also, x is multiplied with y. So what is the power? Power will be the combined power of x and y. When we have more than one variable, we do not call it power, we call it degree. So we can say that the degree of this term, which is xy, is the sum of the powers of individual variables. What are the variables? The variables are x and y. The power of x is 1, the power of y is 1. So the sum of their powers is 1 plus 1, 2. So the degree of this term xy is 2. Now let us calculate the degree of all these terms. What is the degree of x square y cube? We have just learned that the degree is the sum of the powers of variables. So variables here are x and y. Power of x is 2. Power of y is 3. So the degree of this term is 5. What about this? Now we have 2 into a b square c cube. We do not consider the constant term while calculating degree. We simply consider the power of the variables. So we have 3 variables a, b and c. We consider the power of these 3 variables. Power of A is 1, power of B is 2, and power of C is 3. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 gives us 6. So the power of this term is 6. We ignore the power of the constant term, which is 2 here. What is the power of this term? X to the power 5 divided by y to the power 8. Now, when we multiply variables, we add their powers. Division is the inverse of multiplication. So when we divide a variable by another variable, what should we do? We should subtract their powers. Because for multiplication, we add. For division, we should subtract. So the power of x is 5. And we need to subtract the power of y from this, which is 8. So the degree of this term is negative 3. So the degree of a term can also have a negative value. Now what is the degree of PQ square? We have seen that the degree of a term is the sum of the powers of the variables. So in P, Q square, we have two variables, P and Q. The power of P is 1, the power of Q is 2, and their sum is 3. So the degree of this term is 3.